Hello friends, few years back the topic of Rohtang Pass permits used to give headaches to many travelers with ever-changing rules and unclear guidelines. There was nothing but chaos when it comes to applying Rohtang Pass permits when traveling to places like Ladakh or Spiti Valley. However, over the last few years, rules have stabilized and things have really settled down. It is a much streamlined and easier process to get Rohtang Pass permits nowadays. However, the question still comes, how to apply for these permits online or using the mobile app. In my last video of this series on Rohtang Pass permits, I talked about the details on two types of Rohtang Pass permits and some very important points about each of them. Today, in this Express FAQ series on traveling to Ladakh, I'm going to talk about the process of getting the Rohtang Pass permit using the mobile app. So, let's get started. Well, starting 2018-19 season, now tourists traveling to Rohtang Pass can apply for both types of Rohtang Pass permit using the newly launched mobile app by Kullu Administration. The Rohtang Pass mobile app is available for both Android Play Store as well as iOS App Store. This is a very beneficial help from the administration and it helps tourists traveling to Rohtang Pass and beyond Rohtang Pass towards Ladakh, Spiti and Pangi Valley. Personally, I'm very thankful to them for easing out the entire process using this mobile app. Now, let's dive more into the details of Rohtang Pass permits. Firstly, let's talk about what are the documents that you need to apply for Rohtang Pass permits. Well, in order to apply for Rohtang Pass permit, you need to provide a valid photo ID proof. Secondly, a valid pollution under check PUC certificate for your vehicle. Thirdly, the vehicle registration date. Age of the vehicle should not be more than 10 years. Now, talking about the Rohtang Pass permit fee, when you travel just to Rohtang Pass for tourism purposes, then you need to pay a permit fee of Rs. 500 and the congestion charges. The congestion charges mainly depend upon the vehicle, which is for bike, car and regular passenger vehicles, it is Rs. 50. Hence, the total comes out to be Rs. 550 for a Rohtang Pass permit for tourism purposes. But when you're traveling beyond Rohtang Pass, you just need to pay the congestion fee of Rs. 50. But the commercial vehicle needs to pay a fee of Rs. 100. Now, let us talk about some of the key pointers that you need to keep in mind for applying Rohtang Pass permit using the mobile app on your phone. Firstly, this mobile app of Rohtang Pass permit is available both for Android as well as iOS devices. You can check the validity of your permit using the mobile app by scanning the barcode on the permit or entering the permit number. You can also check the status of your Rohtang Pass permit by entering the vehicle number and date of the journey. The permit is displayed on the mobile screen, which you can download as a PDF and take a printout with you. People who are applying for the permit just to travel to Rohtang Pass and not beyond it, they have an option to check the availability of the Rohtang Pass permit in the mobile app. What do I mean by availability? Well, as there is a cap on the number of diesel and petrol vehicles to travel to Rohtang Pass per day, you can check if there is any permit available for the desired date that you want to travel to Rohtang Pass. So, this mobile app comes very handy for the travelers who are interested in just visiting Rohtang Pass. Every year, there is a defined time window for these permits to be applied and they cannot be applied beyond these time windows in a day. Once the permit is issued, it cannot be cancelled. Hence, please be careful when applying for these permits with correct dates and vehicle information so that you do not waste the permit for anyone else. Please note that there is extreme scarcity of Rohtang Pass permits, especially in the season time. So please be responsible for other tourists as well. Please note that there will be only two permits that will be issued per mobile device or IP address in a whole week. So if you are using a shared internet like an office or a college or a cyber cafe internet, the possibility will be someone else would have already applied the permit from it and it will show you the quota full. Hence, apply these permits from a personal computer or a mobile or an internet connection that you think may not have been used to apply these Rohtang Pass permits. Although the details on the website states that if you are having any kind of issues while applying these permits or need any clarification, you can send out an email to dc-kullu-hp@nic.in. However, I'm not sure about the response times. So these were some of the key points for applying Rohtang Pass permits using the Rohtang Pass mobile app. In my honest opinion, this is a great and a welcoming move by the Kullu administration and very much appreciated. In my next and the last video of this Rohtang Pass Permit series, I'll talk about 20 most commonly asked questions about Rohtang Pass Permits. That video will be very interesting, so stay tuned. Now, in the end, if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And in case you have any questions or need any help in planning your upcoming trip to the Himalayas, please feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help you out right away. Till then, my friends, julay, and please keep our Himalayas clean.